I'll keep this short, snappy, a bit of myself. Talisman. Apart from the monsters, the magic, the top goldfish, and the thousand-year-old dinosaur wizard, everything's pretty much true to the area. Okay? Pretty much comes from here. The village of Inverley is a blend of Luss, Fern Bray, and probably Bruce Hill. There's all sorts of people in the book that are basically merged from people here. I won't say who they are, in case they're lawyers. And a lot of dialogue comes from me listening in restaurants and people over talking. I'm a great eavesdropper. So you ever see me the Princess Rose? You're probably better put a few tables away, especially if I've got a new notepad with me. Because dialogue, real dialogue, is a lot better than making it up yourself and some smashed things people say. But what I could say is that this book really for me has been a bit like Willy Wonka's Golden Ticket. I started writing this 12 years ago. It's just out now, this version. And really like the Chocolate Factory, you know, the Challenge Chocolate Factory, this has been a golden ticket for me. I've been awesome to places. I've been to about 100 schools in Scotland, from Orkney to Stornoway. I've been to Germany, talking to children there in Steiner schools. This year I went to Bali to work with 6 schools in the jungle, all because I started writing. And it's been an amazing adventure this year. I stayed in a hut in the jungle, and at night time I had to have a torch look out for cobras, was going to the toilet. And I had to, when I sat, before you went to use the toilet, I had to flick the lid 4 times to be sure no poisonous spiders bit my bum. So thanks for that, yeah. So it's taken me a few places, given me a few adventures. I think the best thing in this book is I've tried to count up nearly 20,000 children in the last 3-4 years or so, all over the world really. And the great thing about the book is hopefully it's acting as a catalyst for the children themselves to get interested in writing and reading and to get into going to the library. When I go to schools, I don't stand up and spout, I get them doing stuff. They start drawing their own characters, doing their own stories, making up their own fables. They come away, hopefully they've done stuff. And hopefully one or two of them go, yeah, I might think about doing some research one day. I also talk about the libraries, how important they are, and how they're like Aladdin's caves and treasure troves in one book. This one book for everybody here will be different in your head. When you start reading it, or you start reading it, or you start reading it, the movie that starts in your head will be different. The characters will look different, the scenery will be different, and that's the magical thing that I think about books. So hopefully, we're going to get a chance to try out this one, which is about a boy whose dad goes missing, and his mum isn't quite socially brilliant. So it's a fancy story, but it's got a lot of family tension in it. I'm going to sign something in if you're interested, but I said I'd keep it short and snappy, so there you go.